Hello, my name is Telekinesis Cat. If you're reading my mind, you're thinking to yourself, your friendly neighborhood YouTuber is rated PG-13. Parental advisory, explicit content. Viewer discretion is advised. You may go about your business while I continue to clean myself. You're welcome and enjoy the show. What's up, everyone? It's your friendly neighborhood YouTuber, ladies and gentlemen, and here we are back at it again with another toy review! Alright, so we have Batman. We have the alternate Batman right here. This, when I first saw this guy, I was kind of on the verge, or on the edge, or on the edge of whether or not I was going to pick him up or not. Simply because we have this Batman right here, this Nightfall Batman. Which, coincidentally enough, he's one of my favorite, he made my list for top 10 figures of 2020 guys. So when I saw this guy, I was kind of reluctant. I didn't pick up the other McFarlane Batman. I did pick up a lot of McFarlane Batman figures, Superman figures, DC figures, but I never picked up that other Batman. I don't know. I've been satisfied with all the McFarlane DC figures so far. A couple actually have made my list for favorite figures of 2020. But when I saw this guy, I was like, you know what? I don't know if I'm going to get him or not. And then I saw him at Walmart. And then I said, I'm going to pick him up. I've always been a fan of the blue and gray look with the yellow logo. As you guys know, I am a sucker for it, man. So this is not only going to be a review of this Batman, but it's also going to be a comparison with this Nightfall Batman, dude. So how good is this Batman, huh? How good is he, guys? So let's go ahead and take the blue scissors. Rightfully so. Slice it open since I'm missing my knife here. I always seem to lose shit, man. Every time I do a toy review, I lose my shit. Well, that comes naturally. I lose my shit naturally, so because I'm crazy. If you guys knew me in real life, then you would understand that I'm crazy and I don't give a shit about a lot of things, man. I say what's on my mind. I speak what's on my mind. I don't really give a fuck if it offends anybody. Kind of like Batman, you know? Like Batman uses his fist. I use my mouth because I got a big fucking mouth and I love to piss people off. Okay, so let's take out this Batman. So he comes with this beautiful chrome. Look at that. Look at that chrome card, dude. Ooh, I want to take a look at that. Let's take a look at this, man. As you guys know, I am fans of trading cards. Ooh, look at this. Look at that chromium. Oh, actually, it's not of the Batman. It's of the other Batman. So they didn't give us a new card with the variant? With the new variant? What kind of bullshit is that, man? Okay, I'm guessing this was the card with the previous Batman, right? Nice, nonetheless. Comes with a stand, which I'm probably not going to use. And then he has just one twisty tie on him. Thank you, McFarlane, if you are listening. Probably not. So, let's take out Batman! The variant Batman. And I like this Batman. I love this cape. I love the blue to this Batman. Very dope figure, man. I'm not upset. The one thing that I disliked about this Batman is this upper piece right here, this upper chest, man. It just looks like he looks bloated at the top, right? He just kind of looks too muscular at the top. He's got a big, big chest for the big, big Bat logo. Let's take a look at his accessories, shall we? So he comes with the Batarang. I guess. I think that's what it's called, right? The Batarang. There's the Batarang. And then he comes with his grapple gun. No! Sorry about that, guys. Almost knocked over my camera. That's what happens when you're a professional YouTuber. Or shall I say unprofessional YouTuber. Like myself. So he comes with this beautiful Batarang. Very nice. I do like it. I'm not going to lie. I do like it. Okay, so let's take a closer look at this Batman. Let's examine him, shall we? What do you guys make of this Batman? I admit, guys, he is pretty. I do like the blue. But he ain't no Nightfall Batman. There are similarities. But this Nightfall Batman is just beautiful. There's one thing I like better. Well, actually, I do like both of these color blues. But I do like the rubberness of this cape, where this cape is more like a plastic hard rubber. Actually, more like a plastic hard plastic. I guess you could say it's rubber. Hard rubber. Hard rubber. There's a million ways I can go with that joke. But, I do like the color of this Batman. I do like the design of the Batman, too. I like this right here, the tread that he has on the side. I don't know how well you guys are seeing that. The tread on the side of his Batman costume. I do like his belt. Boots are very nice. Everything about it is done very nice. I'm just not a fan of this upper chest. I do like the Bat logo. The head sculpt is nice, but if we're doing a comparison between the head sculpts, I think the Nightfall Batman definitely wins, man. It's just way better. Way better. The Bat logo. You know, this is kind of printed on where this is sculpted on right here. So, yeah. I mean, it doesn't really matter as long as the Batman logo looks good. The belt is pretty much the same. I like the muscular attribute of this Batman right here. I love the body design better than the McFarlane. I do like this blue. But the overall body, I think Nightfall Batman still wins, dude. Not taking away anything from McFarlane because he's really, really nice. Now, articulation-wise, I had a problem with this Nightfall Batman, guys. If you guys watched my review, he's not really great articulation-wise because of his weird stomach crunch right there. But he can look down pretty well. He can look up pretty well. But he can barely swivel. This guy, because of this weird upper chest break, he can swivel no problem. He does have a nice bend. He can look up and he can look down like so. Head ball joint. Nice head ball joint. Cape is probably my favorite part of this figure. I love the flimsiness of it. A lot of you guys love the cloth cape look. I still like rubber capes, man. I still like the rubber capes. I'm not going to lie. Even though it's kind of, this guy has the plastic rubber cape, it's kind of a defect with this Batman. I kind of wish he does have a cloth cape, but at the same time, I do like how this cape looks, you know what I mean? Double jointed legs. You can get him in some amazing, amazing poses. Look at that. That right there is the thumbnail. Great articulation. Look at that. Batman can Johnny Cage it. Maybe that's a thumbnail. His legs are on a ball joint movement. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Okay, guys. Really, really nice figure. Okay, before I... You know what? Let's measure this Batman. And then before I give you my rating, this is a comparison video. As you guys know, I love comparing figures. And also, I'm going to break out some McFarlane figures to do a comparison with this Batman. As you see to the left, we have Spawn. I've already showed you the comparison between him and Nightfall Batman. So this Batman stands at about 7 1/4 tall, all the way up to his ears. I like him, guys. I like him a lot. Let's do some comparison. So as you can, as you guys can see, I already have some figures on the table. So here is the Batman with Spawn. What do you guys think? Nice? That's my custom Spawn, if you guys don't know. I like to break out Sugar Man, because I feel like Sugar Man should be in every single one of my reviews. That's how much I love this guy so much. So, let me bring my camera down just a little bit, so I can stand him up. So here's Sugar Man next to Batman. Sugar Man and Batman! They both had the same last name. Man. I'm so stupid. But that's how they measure up. I feel like Sugar Man can be a villain of Batman, right? It just makes sense, Sugar Man and all the crazy, weird villains that Batman has. Speaking of Batman, here is Batman with the Alpha Predator. Bring my camera up just a little bit. That's how they measure up. Nice. To bring in the last review that I recently did, here is the Rhino Alien. Right here, this big motherfucker. That's how they measure up. Right there. I have to lift my camera up to get him in peripheral view. So there's the alien to bring in the big old assassin predator. Here is the assassin predator with Batman. Lift my camera up again. And let's do some other comparisons. If you guys want to see how he looks with the Marvel Legend, here he is with Dr. Doom. So that's how Dr. Doom and Batman measures up. A good size comparison. So let's go ahead and break out some other McFarlane figures and do some comparisons with this Batman. Okay, so we have the Batman next to my Sub-Zero. It's been a while since I broke out my Sub-Zero, but he is a McFarlane figure. And he falls into the 7-inch lineup. So that's how Batman, and plus he's blue too, because I wanted to throw in a blue character. So here's the Batman next to the Sub-Zero. Then here is Hellbat Suit Batman. Very nice, man. They measure up pretty well. I mean, sorry about that, Sub-Zero. I mean, yeah, I think this Nightfall Batman measures up probably better with the Hellsuit Batman. But overall, a nice figure, man. A very, very nice figure. I have to admit, I really, really do like this Batman. I love the coloring to this guy. The overall look is not bad. It's not bad. I mean, looking at this guy in person, he looks nice. Looking at him on camera, this big chest right here, this chest piece, it really bothers me, guys. You know what I mean? It's just not proportionally accurate. It looks like he's wearing a bulletproof vest underneath there. It's not like this, where it's nicely sculpted, you know what I mean? So, but overall, there's no other problem I have with this Batman. It's just the weird chest and that, and this awkward break right here. That is one of the main reasons why I never picked up the Batman, the black and gray version. That's one of the main reasons why I skipped out on that Batman, because I just didn't like the way he looked. But I would have to say I really do like this Batman, man. I like this Batman, man. Let me go ahead and give you my rating. What do I make of this Batman? Jeez. I like the way he looks. I am going to give this guy... I can't give him an 8. It's more along the lines of like a 7, 7.5. 7.5. for this Batman. What do you guys think? What do you guys make of this Batman? I really, really dig him, man. I actually like him. Do I think he's better than this Batman? No. I still think this guy is freaking awesome. But I do like this Batman, specifically his cape. I do like the cape. I do like the color blue. You know, that yellow Batman logo gets me every single time. That yellow utility belt, the blue underwear, the blue boots, the blue gloves, the blue cowl. Am I saying that right? Cowl? But I just think this one is the superior version right here. So if you're looking for a classic Batman in blue, gray, and yellow, I recommend this one over the McFarlane. This one is probably a little bit more pricier simply because he's a little bit more sought after. But not to take away anything from this guy, McFarlane did a great job. He really, really did a great job, guys. So yeah, I do like him. He's definitely a keeper. Tell me what you guys think of this Batman. Do you like him? Do you own him? Which one do you prefer the best? And let's take away McFarlane from the name, okay? This is DC. This is McFarlane. Let's take McFarlane out of the equation. Honest opinion, guys. Who is the better Batman? And let's be honest. Tell me what you guys think. We'll go ahead and leave it at that. There's nothing more I can say. If you guys stuck around all the way to the end, I just want to say thanks. And there you guys have it. There was my review of Batman, the alternate version of Batman. So I want to thank you guys for watching in. I'll catch you guys in the next review. Peace out.